السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. حسبنا الله ونعم المولى ونعم النصير. أفوز أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي كان موجودا قبل حدوث الأشياء ويبقى بعد فناء الأشياء وتفرد بالأولية والقدم ووسم كل شيء ما أداه بالفناء والعدم كما قال عز شانه كل شيء حالك إلا وجهه وكل نفس ذائقة الموت وقال كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام سبحان من لا يخفى عليه اختلاف النيات ولا يعزب عنه معاصي العباد في الخلوات سبحان الله الذي منه خلقة العباد وإليه المعاد فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يرى ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يرى نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا سيد المرسلين وخير المبشرين صلوات صلى الله عليه وآله الهداة المهديين من ركب سفينتهم نجا واهتدى ومن تخلف عنها ضل فغرق وهوى أوصيكم عباد الله وأوصي نفسي بالتقوى الله فإنه حبل متين وأروة وثقى الصلوات. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي عمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ووفقنا وجميع المشتغلين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين صلوات. month of Rajab, and today the day of Friday. When I was just looking at the riwayat, I saw the riwayat that Imam Ali alayhi salatu was salam, he was born on 13th of Rajab, and the day was the day of Friday. So we are covered with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Rajab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says the month of Rajab, Rajabul Asam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pouring the blessing. Sometimes he's showering. There's a difference between shower and pouring. So Rajab is the month when Allah is pouring the blessings. Rajab is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the biggest blessing of this month for me is Imam Ali alayhi salatu wa salam. A poet in Lubnan, when he just recites Imam Ali alayhi salatu wa salam and reads Nahjul Balagha, he says, oh Allah, this is the biggest blessing. Every 100 years, just send one Ali. Ali should come in this time. Because he was saying, Saluni, Saluni, Qabla an tafqiduni. Today we have many inquiries, many questions and answers. We need him today. So he was just saying, oh, God sent him. So he is the biggest blessing. We are attached. We are the followers, or we love Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. We admire him. But today, inshallah, I picked one of the sayings of Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam, who Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam is admiring. We admire Imam Ali, but who the Imam Ali is admiring. So inshallah, I will read. And if I will miss out, then definitely I will miss out. You can go into Najr Balagha. And this is the Kalimat Kisar, and the number is 289. On alislam.org, you can go and you can see 289, inshallah. Inshallah. Last week, we had a good vacation, good holiday, because of the snow. This time also I got the call from Idara. I said, this time also, mashallah, there is no Jummah. Why? Because of the nice weather. Because I lived in Minnesota. When the snow used to come, oh man, forget about it. 6 months you are under snow. But I used to love snow. Beautiful weather. When I have to come or take out my car from the garage, I have to think, oh, everything is white, man. Whether I should come out and put the track on my driveway. Everything is white. Such a beautiful thing. And today, the raining was there, so snow was gone, and nice weather, blue sky, and the clouds. When you see, really, I feel good about the weather. So enjoy the weather. This is the month, very blessed month. If your car is outside your driveway, if it was dirty because of the snow and what you can say, the salt, and your car is washed because of the rainfall, you don't have to take your car for car wash. It's a free car wash from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if my car was in the garage, whether I will get this free car wash? No. If the car is in garage, no, I will not get free car wash. If my car is outside in my driveway, I'll get the free car wash. Same thing, I have to take out my nafs outside. And I should raise my hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the blessed month. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pouring the rain of rahmah, and our car gets washed. This is the month. We should wash our soul. When we say Ghusl al-Jum'ah, we say, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am bathing, I am cleaning my body. But oh Allah, help cleaning my soul. How I can clean my soul? The wiper to clean my soul is istighfar. Istighfar is the best, this is the best month. Astaghfirullah Rabbi wa atubu ilayh. The month of Rajab, and the best dua, the dua which all the duas are dear. We don't need any wordings, but sometimes we have to look for the best wording. The best wording, this comes from Imam alayhi salatu wa salam. Ya man arjuhu likulli khair. Oh Allah, I expect all the good from you. And the last sentence, harrim shaybati alanna. It means, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive my sins. And forgive my sins so I don't want to go into the hellfire. Car is for me. I'm not created for my car. House is for me. I am not created for house. Dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I created dunya for you. You are not created for dunya. So everything which is created for me is a one level below. Food is for me. I am not created for food. I don't know how to say it. Sometimes we are so centric or centered about the food. When we have a breakfast, oh, we have a thinking about it. Oh, what we will have in the lunch. And food centric. Live to eat or eat to live? Live to eat to live. Dunya is for me. Oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no, I created dunya for you. So everything is below. So then what I should look? I should look for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to Jannah, and the way, mashallah, the poets, I love all the shura. The way they were presenting their kalam, and they were talking about the divana, or the, what we can say, majnoon, or the mad of the love of a'imma alayhimu salatu wassalam. One madman, his name is Buhlul. He is the lover of Imam alayhi salatu wassalam. The mad of the love of Imam alayhi salatu wassalam, he can sell Jannah. So Jannah is cheap. He is selling Jannah. He sold Jannah to the wife of Harun. For how much? For 10 bucks. Husband sees in his dream, oh, my wife has a big palace in Jannah. He asks the wife, what you did today? Yesterday, I saw you, you have a big palace. He said, I was just passing by, and Buhlul, the lover, the ashish, the madman of a'imma alayhimu salatu wassalam, he was just playing like a child, and I said, what are you doing? He says, I am making palace in Jannah. He says, do you want to sell it? He says, yes. How much? 10 bucks. So I did justice. Okay. Oh, it's very good deal. I also want to grab the same deal. Again, day after, Harun al-Rashid. And he used to say, oh, the cloud, go and pour your rain wherever you will go. It's my kingdom. That type of man, cruel. He is passing by Buhlul. He says, oh, Buhlul, what are you doing? Same sentence. I am making palaces in Jannah. Is there anything for sale? Yes. He says, I want to buy a couple of them. How much? He says, your kingdom. He says, give me the kingdom. And I will give you just one palace in Jannah. You are not the rightful caliph. Just go away and I'll give you the Jannah. He says, prices go high. 10, 20, 100, 1,000, million. But the whole kingdom? Man, why yesterday it was $10? 10 bucks? Or 10 dirhams or 10 dinar of currency of that time. He said, she bought it yesterday without looking at it. This is madman. He says, you looked at it. And now you want to buy. So what are the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for us? We don't know. This is the month. Insha'Allah, we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, help us that we should fast in this month, we should give charity in this month, we should do it'am. It'am means feeding people. Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam was asked, he says, what are the three things you ask in this dunya? Still I didn't start the riwayah, and I am going. It's the three things I like in this dunya. From your dunya, one, the first thing I like from your dunya is it'amu zayf, feeding the guest. Nowadays, if I say, please call someone, he says, no, Malana, don't call him. Text him. If you will call him, he will get... we even don't call. We just text. And if you call or somebody says, okay, I want to come to your house, he says, man, everything is right. You don't go, guest. I still remember, I said it and I want to say it again and again and again. When I was just raising up. Our house doesn't have any guest room, no guest sofa, but we had guests. Nowadays, oh alhamdulillah, all of us, we have big guest room, big sofas, no guests. Sofas are comfortable, oh, just you can lean. But you are just leaning, no comfort, no sukoon. So guest, he says, I love to feed the guest. Please recite the salawat on Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. These were three things, inshallah, I will say it some more time. Again, Imam alayhi salatu wasalam is admiring, and he says, إِنَّ لِلْقُلُوبِ إِقْبَالًا وَإِتْبَارًا. When we do dua, always we say, سَبِّتْ قَلْبِي. We don't say, سَبِّتْ جِسْمِ. No, we say, سَبِّتْ قَلْبِي عَلَى دِينِكَ. Our du'as, Ya Muqallib al-Qulub. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you change the qulubs. If you see the graphs of the heart, it goes ups and downs. Spiritually, sometimes we are up. Spiritually, sometimes we are down. This is the spiritual month. So Imam alayhi salatu wasalam says, Inna lil-Qulubi. إِنَّ لِلْقُلُوبِ شَحْوَةَ إِقْبَالًا وَإِتْبَارًا. Sometimes, oh, you are in a good mood. You feel like doing ibadah. That is the best opportunity to do ibadah. And sometimes when you are not in a mood, no ibadah, not even wajibat, no. We have to do ibadah, bare minimum. Like he said, when your heart is inclined towards doing more ibadah, reading Nahjul Balagha, that is the time just do more ibadah. And when your heart doesn't want it, just stay yourself, limit yourself to wajibat. Don't just take it hard. Like we are petting, we have to pet our nafs too. And we have to put it on the track. Because if you will just force yourself, Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam says, فَإِنَّ الْقَلْبِ إِذَا أُكْرِحَ أَمِيَا. They will become blind. Like once a person, he says, okay, I want to become a Muslim. He says, okay, come. And he took him for the namaz so. And then he says, okay, namaz-e sobh, then he was happily going. He says, why are you going? Where are you going? We will have a namaz-e zohar time and then namaz-e asr time. These people, they go five times, we go three times. So don't pressure. When it comes to kids, don't pressure on them. If they put the hijab and they want to pray, okay, lead the prayers over them in jama'ah. Don't force. If you will force them, you will break the connectivity. So this is the Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, and this is the hadith. Now, the thing which I said, I promise, and inshallah I will start. Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam, again, 289, Nahjul Balagha. He says, Kana li akhun mimma maza. This is Imam. He is saying, I had a brother. And I liked him very much. He is Imam alayhi salatu wasalam is admiring. We admire Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. Imam is admiring this brother. What qualities he has? He says the first quality he had. He says it may be Malik Ashtar, it may be Salman al-Farsi, it may be Abu Zar, it may be Miqdad. The elite companion of Imam alayhi salatu wasalam at that time. Imam was so much respectful that when the Prophet was alive, he was not talking. And he's saying, I had a friend and he passed away. So Imam alayhi salatu wasalam says, oh, and Imam, why he's liking that man? The first quality. Ittifad rood padhiye Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. كان يعظمه في صغر الدنيا في عينه. Means dunya was very little in his eye. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam says, there are ahlul dunya and ahlul akhirah. Ahlul dunya, if they miss some of their dunya, oh, they make a big fuss. But ahlul akhirah, they are concerned about their akhirah, not dunya. If they miss some dunya, oh, don't care. But if they miss some akhirah, it's a big thing. Like if I miss, or somebody missing namaz, oh, no problem. It's not a big deal. But if I miss a deal, oh man, the whole house is in trouble. Why? I missed that deal. Why you didn't remind me? I wish I had bought this thing. This thing was $100 and now it became $1,000. The missing dunya is a big thing. Missing akhirah, nothing. But Imam alayhi salatu wasalam says dunya is too little in his thing. Having dunya is not a problem. But making dunya as an object, he says, لا تنس نسيبك من الدنيا. We say, ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة. But again, dunya is for me or I am for dunya. So Imam is giving first message. He says, I am admiring him. He is not looking at dunya, that dunya is the main thing. No, dunya is nothing for me. If he gets, he is happy. If he doesn't get, oh, no problem. So the first thing, لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسُوا عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَهُوا عَلَى مَا أَعْتَاكُمْ. If the dunya is taken from him, no worries. If you just give him dunya, his blood pressure is intact, he gets a million, blood pressure, his mood, his akhlaq. Sometimes if a people becomes wealthy, oh, you can see him by attitude. Oh, no. Yeah, he is. It means he was not able to digest the dunya. So, لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسُوا عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَهُوا عَلَى مَا آتَاكُمْ. He is not going after dunya. Dunya is coming after him. He is working for dunya, but dunya is not the big thing. Second thing. كان خارجا من سلطان بطنه. When he is living in his dunya, his major concern is not the food. Oh, then my breakfast, what we have for the dinner. It means living to eat or eat to live. The third thing, كان أكثر دهره صامتا. Most of the time he is maintaining silence. Oh, our thing, we maintain silence, but we are just saying, okay, your turn is done now, I'm just thinking, let me talk. But this man, no, he is a good listener. Allah is Sami. And he is a good listener. And says, Kana aksaru dahrihi samita. And when somebody is asking him a question, he gives a very complete and very satisfying answer. It means his knowledge is good and he's maintaining silence. Here I'm reminding of Sayyid Sistani. People, what they were just saying, oh, why he's not talking? Maharaj, when you go, oh, they maintain their silence. But when they talk, the world is moving. When there was an attack on Iraq, and when Sayyid Sistani, when he started speaking, the whole world was on the other side and he was just talking. So when they talk, ajib. Kana zaifan mustaz'afa. When you see him, their real appearance is zaif mustaz'af. I don't know how to translate. Zaif means a weak person. Mustaz'afa. Oppressed person. But when comes and when he goes to the battle, he is the same Zaif? Oh, no, he is not some Zaif. فَإِنْ جَاءَ الْجِدُّ فَهُوَ لَيْسٌ فِي الْغَابِ. When the war comes and when the chief comes, he becomes a lion. Not Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, he becomes a lion. He says he becomes like a big serpent. We become lion at our home. But in the battlefield, he says he is a lion. But normally when you see, yo, he is just a mustaz'af. Malik Ashtar. Nobody knows who Malik Ashtar. Like in Malik Ashtar used to fight and go. People at that time, there was no WhatsApp, nothing. So they don't know the images and everything. He is the commander in chief. When he comes, so one of the person, he just made a joke of him and he did something. So Malik Ashtar started walking. He was going to offer 2 rakat namaz. Somebody told him, "Oh, you made fun of him. You know who he is?" He says, "I don't know." He says, "He is Malik Ashtar, commander-in-chief of the army of Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. You are done. You are doomed. You made fun of him?" So he says, "Okay, let me go and see, apologize." So he just came to, he says, "I came to masjid for you, just to ask forgiveness for you and forgiveness for my soul." So they were very powerful when it comes to fight in the battlefield. But in the real life, you will see him, they are like Zaif Mustaza'af. لا يلوم أحدا إلا يجد الأذر في مثله. They will not, what we can say, she say, and they won't do malamat, they don't do reprimand anyone else, and they are ready to accept the excuses. When it comes to excuses, so we don't accept excuses. Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, somebody comes in your right ear and he abuses, he says bad word. And he comes in your right ear and he's excuse, forgive him. Forget and forgive him and forget. So these are the people who accepts the excuses. So inshallah, see if I can do it one more in the next khutbah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal asr. Innal insana lafi khusr. إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم لك الحمد بديع السماوات والأرض ذا الجلال والإكرام رب الأرباب وإله كل مألوه وخالق كل مخلوق ووارث كل شيء ليس كمثله شيء وهو بكل شيء محيط أنت الله لا إله إلا أنت الأحد المتوحد. إك دفع درود بري محمد وآل محمد بر. Inshallah, I will finish this in tomorrow's Nahj al-Balagha class. I will put the presentation, so you will also help me, and we will read this. And the last sentence Imam says, try to be like that man. If you cannot copy him in all of them, just come and copy some of the attribute of these people. Nahjul Balagha. Do any of the Khalifa has Nahjul Balagha? Anyone has anything which is worth like Nahjul Balagha? Ar-Rahman Allama al-Quran. We have to go to the madrasa to learn Quran. O Allah, to who you taught the Quran? Ar-Rahman Allama al-Quran. He taught Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam. Ah, He had the knowledge. He says, Ha huna ilmun jamman jamma. I have the knowledge. I want to give. But I don't want to give you the heavy dose. He used to go in the outskirts of Kufa and he used to pour his knowledge in that well. So now we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, hasten in the reappearance of the son of Ali. Imam Zamana alayhi salatu wa salam. So we see all these atrocities, all the zulm. Inshallah, all the zulm again. When the son of Fatih Khaybar comes, he will again show them. And وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظُلِمُوا أَيَّا مُنْقَلِبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ This doesn't remain the same. Don't do zulm. If you are doing zulm, a day will come that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care. So our heart goes to this oppressed people of Palestine. We were under snow and we were just feeling uncomfortable sometimes, uneasy. I enjoy it. But they are showering the bombs. Showering the bombs. On hospitals, on everything. Sometimes the humanitarian service, like the news shows, it's become a big news. A cat was into the well, helicopter is coming up, and they are just rescuing the animals, rescuing the horse. It become big news. But when it comes to the Palestinian people, we are rescuing, or what are you doing? I don't know. But day will come. We are waiting for that divine leader in this month, inshallah, on the 13th of Rajab, Ilahi Bihaq Ali, hasten in the reappearance of Imam alayhi salatu wasalam. Wassalatu wasalam ala Muhammadin Nabi al-Rahman Sayyid al-Mursaleen wa ala Ali ibn Abi Talib wa Fatima al-Zahra wa Hassan al-Mujtaba wa Hussein al-Shahid bi Karbala wa Ali ibn al-Hussein wa Muhammad ibn Ali wa Jafar ibn Muhammad wa Musa ibn Jafar wa Ali ibn Musa wa Muhammad ibn Ali wa Ali ibn Muhammad wa al-Hassan ibn Ali wa al-Khalaf al-Qaim Allahumma salli ala Muhammad الذي بيمنه رزق الورى وبوجوده ثبتت الارض والسماء به يملا الارض قسطا وعدلا بعدما ملئت ظلما وجورا اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات انك مجيب الدعوات إنك على كل شيء قدير بالرحمة